Eyewitness News 5's Brandon Beyer spoke with Tim's coach as well as his brother. He's live tonight with the team coverage. Brandon?
Jessica, Tim's coach Randy Wilson doing so much for this family. He set up that fund. He's helping organize dances at the school to raise money. We sat down with Tim's two brothers today. They can't believe how the school is coming together for this family.
Yeah, I remember we was on the back of the bus talking about those fruit baskets.
Tim's brothers Michael and Tony have a lifetime of memories of their brother on the football field.
But this is my senior year, so I thought it'd be great to play with my brothers again.
All three moved to Centennial High School this year to play together. They had no idea they'd be surrounded by such support.
No one's ever prepared for a situation like this, and just trying to help everybody out as much as we can.
They didn't have to do that. Like, nobody had to come together with us. They could have just did their job and kept going on about their business, but they came for us and they donated and gave, and now they still doing stuff for us and for our family, so.
Now this week, students are wearing buttons with Tim's football picture, a junior wide receiver and defensive back who loves so much more than just the game.
Bright smile, a guy that enjoyed life, a guy that enjoyed people, enjoyed being involved in a lot of activities from athletics to leadership roles.
Now, Tim's coach has also challenged Centennial's principal to what they're calling a bedlam fundraiser. He's OU, she's OSU, and the team that raises the least amount of money, they have to wear the other school's jerseys for an entire day. We're live in the studio. Brandon Beyer, Eyewitness News 5.
Brandon, thank you. And Tim Morland's funeral is Friday morning at Prospect Church on North Missouri Avenue.